way out here in the dry shade where I don't really check on it very often, I've got a patch of butcher's broom, Ruscus aculeatus, growing. There's a stalk of it there that's harboring some usnea lichen. These are the very showy fruits of the plant. Squeeze one apart. And you can see the cartilaginous seed that's inside. They're single-seeded. Here it is. We'll definitely save that for planting. What appear to be leaves are actually flattened stems known as cladodes, although I like to call them cladudes for obvious reasons, even though technically they would be dudes and dudettes. They're dioecious, male and female, flowers on different plants, and in a strange quirk of nature, the flowers occur on the side of the clade. There's another one. This is a relic plant. It dates back to the tertiary 66 million years ago. Started up right after the dinosaurs died out. Native to the Mediterranean and the British Isles. It is related to asparagus. You can see that asparagus-like stem on it. The aerial parts were once used scouring butcher's blocks. They had a sort of an antibacterial influence. The roots are wiry and fibrous and have been used from early times as a treatment for varicosities and hemorrhoids. The plant contains steroidal saponins, which have a tendency to reduce vascular permeability. So it basically keeps the blood inside the capillary bed. A truly odd plant. I feel honored to have it. No matter how old I get, I'm still young in comparison. I was once discussing it with a fellow plant enthusiast. We were at Golden Gate Park, and he said the seeds were literally impossible to germinate. So I reached down in the substrate, and I found one that had already thrown a root. Somehow I just knew it was there. And I lifted it up and showed him. Nyeh, 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 nyeh. Seeds available online at Strictly Medicinal Seeds. The rarer, the more unusual, the more medicinal, the more ancient, and the redder, the better.